session, we are going to discuss national income and how it is being calculated by value-added method. National income of the country can be measured by three methods. Value-added, it is also called output and product method, income method and distribution method. Expenditure method, it is also called disposition method. All the three methods give the same estimate of national income. In this method, there are two approaches, final product approach and value-added approach. Final product approach, here final product also called gross domestic product. Here GDP is monetary value of all final goods and services in domestic territory in an accounting year. It is estimated by multiplying gross product with market price. GVO, that is gross value output at market price, is equal to price into output plus change in stock plus goods produced from self-consumption. GVO at market price is also known by sales plus change in stock. That is, the goods are being produced for self-consumption. Here you have to keep in note that it is gross, thus it includes depreciation. Being at MP, that is market price, it includes net indirect taxes. Today it is called GST, that is goods and services tax. Now what are the precautions you have to keep in mind? Value of only final goods and services included to avoid problem of double counting. Value added approach, here national income is calculated by adding net value added at factor cost. Here by adding net factor income from abroad to domestic income, that is net domestic factor income at factor cost, we get national income, and the formula is NNP at factor cost. Here domestic income is estimated at the stage of production, that is at the stage of value addition. GVA at market price or GDP at market price is equal to GVO at market price minus intermediate consumption. And if you want to calculate NVA at factor cost, that is net value added at factor cost, is equal to gross value added at market price minus depreciation minus NIT. What is NIT? Net indirect taxes. Now there are steps to calculate national income by value added method. So first of all, you have to identify the production units. There are three production units: primary sector, which exploits natural resources, mining, agriculture, fishing, etc. Secondary sector, which transforms one commodity into other, clothes produced from cotton. Tertiary sector renders services, for example, banking and insurance. In step two, you should know how to apply the formula. First of all, in order to calculate GDP at market price, always keep in mind that value-added method is calculated at market price. GVO at market price is equal to sales plus change in stocks plus goods produced for self-consumption. Now one more point you have to keep in mind, that whenever in the numerical domestic sales are given, then you have to add exports plus closing stock minus opening stock. So other name for that is change in stock. GVA at market price or GDP at market price is equal to GVO market price minus intermediate consumption, and we get gross value added at market price. Here also you have to take in care that whenever domestic purchase is given, then you have to add imports in that. In the third step, we need to calculate NDP. NDP at factor cost, that is net domestic product at factor cost, is equal to GDP at market price minus depreciation minus NIT. Calculation of national income, that is NNP at factor cost. So NDP at factor cost plus NFIA, net factor income from abroad. You also have to keep in mind whether from is given or to. From minus to is NFIA, but if from is given, you have to add. If to is given, you have to deduct. Now following items should be included, and here we are discussing some precautions of value added method. First item which should be included is value of final goods and services. imputed rent of owners occupied houses, imputed value of goods produced for self-consumption by producers, imputed value of fixed assets produced for self-consumption by enterprises, government and households, imputed value of free services produced by government and non-profit institutions. Now you have to keep in mind that following items should not be included: sales and purchase of second-hand goods, sales and purchase of shares and bonds, either they are new or old, production by illegal activities like smuggling, theft, etc., value of intermediate goods and services to avoid double counting, services produced for self-consumption. Problem of double counting. Problem of double counting means counting of the value of the same product for more than once. For example, there are four producers: farmer, miller, baker and confectioner. So let us see in the table that value of the output is given: 2000, 2500, 3600, 4000, and it is 12,100 is the total. Now if a layman checks and they are being asked to calculate GDP, they will simply calculate this, but this is not correct. If we take value of 12,100, then it is due to double counting. Here value of wheat included 4 times, flour 3 times and bread 2 times. The final value of the bread is 4,000 only, that is 12,100 minus 8,100 is equal to 4,000. So this calculation is being shown in the third column. So the first column value of the output, you have to deduct intermediate consumption, that is 2500 minus 2000 is equal to 500 and so on. Because in the first column 2000, there is no intermediate consumption, so the value added is only 2000. And the gross value added in the third column is 4000. So as an economic student, you should take care that you have to take only this 4000 value. Now let us also learn how to calculate by applying the formulas and doing and solving numericals. So here is the one numerical. Domestic sales is given, change in stock is given, depreciation. Now first of all, you need to calculate GVO at market price, that is sales plus change in stock. So domestic sales are given plus change in stock is given, so you get 3400. Then you need to calculate GDP at factor cost, that is GVO at market price minus intermediate consumption minus NIT, and you get 1150 crores. So you have to take care that when domestic sales is given, then how you have to solve the question. So exports have been added, this 500 value. Now in the second numerical, you see you have to calculate sales. So net value added at factor cost is given, intermediate consumption is given. So first of all, we will calculate GDP at market price, that is NDP at factor cost plus depreciation plus NIT. And we will put the values 300 plus 30 plus 20 minus 10. And then after that, GVO at market price, that is GDP at market price plus intermediate consumption. Finally, we calculate GVO at market price, that is sales plus change in stock. So in the previous question, you have seen that you started from sales plus change in stock. But this formula is coming in the end. Why? Because here one item that is missing, that is sales. Okay, so that's why we started with the GDP. And net value added at factor cost is given. So this is the way to calculate the sales by this value added method. Thank you.